And I've got a big layer adhesion test with 10 different 3D printers. I will use the same materials and same print temperatures. Of course, the printer type will be different, the nozzle material and print speed will be different too. So what do you think? Will we see bigger differences between these test objects? Or the layer adhesion will be similar? I don't know. Let's find out. Welcome back. Again, that layer adhesion, the big point of our 3D printed objects. And actually the idea came from my viewers who asked me why I'm using mostly the same printer for my testings. Well, the reason is simple, because I want to results be comparable with those which I did in earlier videos. And I already tested P1P and X1C, and P1P was better in this test for the layer adhesion because it has brass nozzle. So yes, probably there will be some difference, especially with the speeds. In my testing, there will be some printers which are very slow, and of course there are one which are very fast. The material I will use is the Creality Hyper PLA. Always I get the comments why I'm using the Bamboo Labor Polymaker filaments, probably I'm sponsored by them. No, I'm not, unfortunately. The Hyper PLA will be in white color and it has a recommended print temperature between 190 and 230 degrees Celsius. Well, I decided to go with 220 degrees Celsius for all printings, even on those slower printers, because this is what I'm curious about. And the speed will be the default settings in the slicer for that printer. Beside my test objects, sometimes I have to add some other objects too, because I don't want to printing slow down because of the minimal layer printing time. So I'm printing some dies or something like that next to it. I'm very curious what results we will get. So let's see, 10 different printers and the layer adhesion.
This is Creality K1 Max. And in the corner you can see the speeds. It has a bimetal nozzle, this means inner part is from hardened steel. This is Prusa Mark IV with the brass nozzle. And this is one of the slowest in this test. And then I'm placing this ring to this carbon spool because it goes to the AMS system. This is a P1P with a stock brass nozzle. This is Bamboo Lab X1 Carbon with a hardened steel nozzle. This is Kiddy X-Max 3 with a brass nozzle. Bamboo Lab A1 brass nozzle and the 3S1, and next to the Prusa, this is the second slowest printer in this test. FL Sun Super Racer, quite fast for its age. And this is Sovol SV08, the fastest printer in this test. And this is Creality K1 with a stock brass nozzle. I also measured the mass to see if there will be any significant difference between these test objects. And only with the one test object I can see that it is lighter, that is Sovol SV08. And this can be also visible on this graph, so more or less similar mass, only Sovol SV08, it is lighter, almost 10%, so that's significant under extrusion. I marked here a 60mm line. I extruded exactly 50mm, and instead of 10, I have here 16mm. So I have to change the rotation distance in the printer configuration file. And after this change, I repeated the test, and this time correctly 10mm left after the same extrusion test. So it is fixed now. And I repeated this printing with corrected flow rate and rotation distance. And now let's measure it again, 3.58 grams, and this fits perfectly into this graph compared to the others. And here you can see me in the action, this is my measuring method, the rate is 1 to 3. And side by side, Creality K1 Max, these are the average values, Prusa Mark IV, Bamboo Lab P1P, Bamboo Lab X1C, Kiddy X-Max 3, Bamboo Lab A1 and the 3S1, and this one I have to repeat, I'll explain soon. FL Sun Super Racer, Sovol SV08 with under extrusion, and SV08 fixed. Creality K1. When I get so extreme results, always check the settings, and here notice I forget to change. I use the NDS3 V2 profile, but it has a Bowden-style extruder and the retraction here is 5 mm. But for direct drive extruder, we need to set this value approximately to 1 mm. I reprinted the test objects and this time the brake load was closer to 50 kg like with the other printers.
I didn't know that the retraction has so big effect to the layer adhesion, and this is something I want to investigate a little bit deeper, but for myself. I mean, if you would like to see a video about it, then write me down in the comments on which printer should I test this to see different retraction, maybe 0, 1, 2, 3 millimeters to the layer strength. Now back to analyzing.
For the moment, I will show you the table with all data included. And these are the final results, NDS3 with corrected retraction and SOVOL with corrected flow rate. More or less around 50 kilograms. Interesting to see that the two slowest printers has slightly weaker layer adhesion. Maybe this is because of the slower printing and the layer has more time to cool down. Not sure about this. About Creality K1, well, this is one of those early products where that extruder has some problem on higher flow rates. I already measured this in my review video. If I increase the speed, the flow rate slows down. And with this, maybe I should reduce the speed. In that case, I should get similar values. About FSN Super Racer, well, here we have a little bit bigger brake load, but also these test objects were the heaviest. About SOVOL SV08, I'm not sure why we have so extreme data. I repeated this test and again I got similar values, but the weight of the test objects is correct now. Maybe because it used the nickel-plated copper and not brass nozzle. I'm not sure about this, but this is very interesting. Just quick note, pay attention, all three Bembole printers from this test has very similar numbers, but also the deviation is very small. This means they are very good for this kind of testing and just confirmed that I made a good decision when I decided for the future filament testing I'm using Bembole printers.
Another big work is finished and I hope you appreciate this compact version of the video, which will be shorter than 10 minutes, which is not good for my channel, but I don't really care. So what is your opinion? Somebody recently analyzed my channel and make a conclusion that I have a very smart, active audience, so I'm really proud of you guys. And don't forget, if you would like to get the notifications about similar uploads, you should click that notification bell button too, because in most cases the notification is not sent if you are only a subscriber. Not sure why, but this is the situation. Anyway, thank you for watching and happy printing!